Hey guys, Spirit of the Law here. I think we can agree it's easy to get caught up in quickly putting down farms in the late game. You hold down shift, do some circular clicking, and it's good enough. There's lots going on you'd rather pay attention to, but deep down you know you're doing something bad and should feel guilty, right? That is, unless you're playing Khmer, in which case, carry on. I'd expect every player has been criticized for poorly placed farms at one point or another, and farm shaming is rampant in the community. In this video, I'll show you why poorly placed farms actually aren't that bad, at least in the late game. I looked into it, and I think the results will surprise you. Let's check it out. We'll start things off by establishing a baseline for ideal farms with the classic pinwheel. I played as Franks in post-imperial and let them farm for 10 minutes at 1.7 speed. Typically, farms on the right side collect a bit faster than the ones on the left of a mill or town center, but in this case, aside from one outlier, that pattern didn't show up. This small fact foreshadows a bit of what's to come. Just to quickly address the Slavs who have 10% faster farming, over 10 minutes I found they were almost exactly 10% faster as advertised. When you think about it, that's kind of weird though. If they're farming 10% faster, then after all the walking around, you'd think it should be something less than 10% in the end. Of course, the explanation is the farm itself is hard-coded to only produce a certain amount of food per minute. Technically, Slav farmers are able to collect 18% faster than usual, but more importantly, the farms are growing food 10% faster. For most civilizations, farms grow 0.4 food per second once they're constructed, and farmers gather at 0.53 food per second. Even after including walking time, they still end up being able to collect slightly faster than the farm produces. For a clear demonstration, I'm letting one villager here start collecting immediately after his farm is built, and the other starts about 10 seconds later. If we fast forward, after a bit of time, we find the two farmers are completely in sync when dropping off. That's exactly what we would expect if it's the farm limiting the collection rate. Theoretically, we could increase the walking distance to the farm, and as long as the speed the farm can actually grow the food is still the bottleneck, you aren't hurt by that extra distance. Naturally, the question then is how messy can we make the farms before we see a significant drop of 5 or 10% in food collection? To answer that, we'll look at a series of worsening farm layouts. Any farm collecting between 23.7 and 24 food per minute is going to be represented by blue, as it's almost indistinguishable from ideal farming. Any farming rate below 23 food per minute is red, and its poor placement is costing you one or more food per minute. Anything in between is going to be labeled yellow. Of course, we'll start with a control group that's well placed, and I'll then move every farm one tile away laterally. I'll then reset and move each farm one tile diagonally, so overall a bit farther, and then a trial with a diagonal and lateral move together. The next test will be one tile further away from there, and finally, some truly terrible looking farms that are one more tile away. Hopefully for each of these, you have an idea in your head of how much of a drop you're expecting. At what point have we lost, say, 5% of our farmer's efficiency, and where would 10% be? Take a guess and we'll see how your intuition checks out. Jumping back to the baseline, we're looking at 23.89 food per minute on average, and inspecting every farm after 10 minutes for their collection rate, we see them all performing well. There's a slight drop on the far left side, but 23.7 and above we'll say is still essentially ideal. If we take every single farm and move them away from the mill one tile to what some might criticize as poorly placed farms, we get a drop of just 1% in collection rate. That's not bad at all, and half are still collecting in the blue zone with essentially ideal farming. For most of these farms, the bottleneck is still how quickly the food is being grown, though a couple on the left side are starting to drop. If instead we move the farms one tile diagonally, they're slightly further away on average and we see a corresponding decrease, but it's still just 1.3% less than the baseline. That doesn't seem that bad considering how haphazardly they look like they were thrown down. Combining a diagonal with a lateral move away from the mill, we now have some questionable farms. This is probably worse than someone holding shift and randomly throwing down farms would get, and yet it's only a 3.1% drop. If we take out the worst farm on the left side, it's only 2.5%. We are starting to get to the point you could argue it's a notable decrease, but with 50 farmers, it's roughly the equivalent of having one of them idle. There's still two left here though. If we move all the farms one further away, the limiting factor is pretty clearly the walking time, and now it's a 5% drop. Give yourself a pat on the back if this is the one you thought was 5%. Even still, that means 20 farmers placed like this are collecting as much as 19 perfectly placed ones. Last one here, going yet another tile further away with some truly eye-watering farms, we get a drop of about 7.7%. Essentially, 13 farmers like this are working as much as 12 perfectly placed ones. That's not an overwhelming difference, but if this is what your farms look like when you're doing them quickly, it might be worth slowing down a bit. Amazingly, even this layout didn't give a 10% drop in efficiency. Now this all might be a bit surprising, but I want to address a misconception that might happen at this point. You might think this means that farm placement never matters, and that would be a very unfortunate takeaway. Everything here is with full upgrades, so villagers are carrying 21 food per trip and are walking at their maximum speed. I ran the test again, first with no upgrades, and again with wheelbarrow and heavy plow, so basically everything except handcart. And I'll show you why this does not generalize to the early game. Going back and re-establishing the baselines, I don't think it's blowing any minds that upgrades help farming. Wheelbarrow and heavy plow together bump farming by about 14%, and handcart gives another 6.5%. What's interesting is how much larger the impact of poor farming is if you don't have handcart. Going to the first layout with farms moved one tile away from the mill, with handcart we saw a 1% drop. If you have all of your upgrades except handcart though, you're losing 4.4%. Trying it again with no upgrades, even just this small movement of farms, means losing 6.6% of your efficiency. In Dark Age, introducing a few gaps like this between farms has a larger impact on your collection rate than placing farms like this in the late game. In other words, you should be less critical of farms like this in the late game than this in the early game. For comparison, without handcart, you'd be losing 17.8% with farms like this, and almost 22% if you place farms like this in Dark Age. Now obviously most players don't put down farms this poorly, but doubling up and even tripling up farms can happen. And the main takeaway here is simply that before handcart, every bit you move your farms away from the drop-off point has an impact. In the early game, being a bit of a farming perfectionist does pay off. The other big point is that while wheelbarrow is great for farming, it's specifically handcart that allows you to mostly stop worrying about good farm placement. To give you a visual guide, here I've mapped the individual farm rates on top of each other, and based on what I saw, any farm placed entirely in the farming area shown here collects 23 or more food per minute with handcart. That would be at least 96% of ideal, which I consider quite good. If you had 50 farms, for example, the difference between all of them being perfectly placed and all of them being as bad as possible while still in this zone works out to a difference of about 2 idle farmers. Notice it's a bit more forgiving on the right side as well because of the exact farming mechanic. The big takeaways are first that early game farm placement is always important. At the same time, if you're always perfectly placing farms in the late game after handcart, there might be better ways to spend your time. You could probably get more value from your attention by double checking you have your upgrades and controlling your armies rather than meticulous farm placement. Of course, there is an upper limit to that, and once you're outside of that Goldilocks zone, as it were, the efficiency does drop off fairly quickly. A slight bias to placing farms on the right side of the mill can help a bit, and also make sure after you place your farms that you click on the mill without shift, so they build that first and then automatically go to their own farm. In this case, I have near perfect efficiency in a process that took just under 5 seconds. That said, if you're quick with perfect farms and prefer the look of them that much, I wouldn't say there's anything wrong with them. The main point is it's wasting time to agonize over getting them just right, and there's better ways to invest your time and attention. So hopefully that puts the importance of late game farm placement into some perspective. Shout out to Jean-Paul, James, Matthew, Daniel, Noah, Gabe, Brian, Paul, Samantha, and everyone else on Patreon for supporting the channel and what I do. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.